Hi friends, welcome to JSM. In this video, I am going to explain formation of bond in molecules. In previous video, I have explained overlapping of atomic orbitals. So here different types of overlappings already explained. So now by using that, how is bond is forming in between atoms in a molecule. So for example, now here it is the first example I am taking H2 molecule. Okay, so now hydrogen atomic number 1, electronic configuration 1s1. So now in s orbital we have an electron. So now here two hydrogens. So now two s orbital. So now it is first hydrogen and here it is the second hydrogen having each one electron. So now overlapping of this we are getting. So right here it is. Okay. So this is the formation of H2 molecule. This is hydrogen atom and hydrogen atom. So now between hydrogen atoms here it is a bond formed. So now whenever s orbital is involving in overlapping, compulsory the formation of which bond? Sigma bond takes place. So now second example I am taking hydrogen fluoride. We know that hydrogen already s orbital is there in the fluorine, atomic number 9, electronic configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p5. This is the outermost electronic configuration. So now here it is a 2s2, 2p5, 1 2 3 4 5. So now this is the pz orbital is having unpaired electron. So now this is the pz orbital of fluorine and s orbital of hydrogen. So which overlapping? Compulsory linear overlapping. Formation of which bond is taking place? Sigma bond. Already I said whenever we have s orbital, compulsory formation of which bond? Sigma bond only. So now this is the s orbital of hydrogen and it is the p orbital of fluorine. So now here it is bond formed. What is this? Sigma bond. So now this is hydrogen fluoride. Formation of hydrogen fluoride. Next example is a nitrogen molecule. Nitrogen atomic number is 7, electronic configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p3. This is the outermost electronic configuration. So now 2s2, 2p3. Okay, 2s2, 2p3. Now nitrogen. Okay, so now internuclear axis I am taking pz, and here py and px. First nitrogen atom, this is nitrogen atom. Second nitrogen atom, okay, so this is a internuclear axis, same py orbital and px orbital. So each orbital having one unpaired electron of first nitrogen atom and second nitrogen atom also having one unpaired electron in each orbital. So already I have explained, so when orbitals are in linear manner or axial manner, so their formation of sigma bond taking place. So now between these orbitals, so now here it is a formation of pi bond, because here it is linear overlapping is not possible. Linear overlapping is not possible. Formation of pi bond takes place here. So now this is the structure of a nitrogen molecule. So between two nitrogen atoms, so now one sigma bond and two pi bonds are forming. So now this is the structure of a nitrogen molecule. Let us discuss structure of methane molecule. Structural formula CH4, central element is carbon,
carbon atomic number is 6, electronic configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p2. So 2s2, 2p2 is the outermost electronic configuration. Outermost electronic configuration, and it is also known as what? Ground state electronic configuration. Ground state electronic configuration. So now, whenever we give energy to this orbital, this is the electron excited into p orbital. This is the process is known as excitation. Excitation. And one electron excited into this, this is also known as what? First excited state electronic configuration. First excited state electronic configuration. So now here it is 1, 2, 3. So in excited state, this is the s orbital, these are the p orbitals. So now total 4 orbitals are available at carbon atom. Carbon atom. So now, second element is what? Hydrogen. We know that electronic configuration 1s1. So total how many hydrogens are there? 4 hydrogens are there. So we will get 4 1s1 orbitals. 4 1s1 orbitals. So now these 4 1s1 orbitals of hydrogen overlapping with this atomic orbitals of carbon. So now here I am writing, so this is s orbital, these are p orbitals. Okay, so now s orbital of hydrogen and s orbital of hydrogen. So now 4 s orbitals of 4 hydrogen atoms, and here it is 1 s orbital and 3 p orbitals of carbon. So now this is overlapping between s orbital of carbon, p orbital, s orbital of carbon, s orbital of hydrogen. So like that, p orbital of carbon, s orbital of hydrogen, p orbital, s orbital, p orbital, s orbital. So this is the overlapping is taking place between atomic orbitals of carbon and hydrogen. So now, so first I am taking carbon atom. So now this is the s orbital of carbon atom. Okay, so now this is the s orbital of carbon atom is overlapping with the s orbital of hydrogen. So now here I am taking s orbital of hydrogen. So here one bond is formed. Bond is formed. So first p orbital or pz orbital of carbon. So it is also overlapping with hydrogen. 1s orbital of hydrogen. So formation of another sigma bond. So here it is a p orbital, second p orbital of carbon. So here also overlapping with the hydrogen, s orbital of hydrogen. Okay, third p orbital of carbon, it is also overlapping with s orbital of hydrogen. So this is the, these are the bonds are forming in the formation of methane molecule according to VBT. According to VBT. So here I am showing full orbitals of carbon atom. So right, this is the complete structure of methane molecule according to valence bond theory. According to valence bond theory. According to VBT. So now according to VBT. According to VBT, so here 4 bonds are formed. Out of 4 bonds, one bond is formed between s orbital of carbon and s orbital of hydrogen. S orbital of carbon and s orbital of hydrogen. So remaining 3 bonds are formed. P orbitals of carbon and s orbitals of hydrogen. S orbitals of hydrogen. So according to VBT, here we are getting 2 types of bonds in the formation of methane molecule. Methane molecule. But experimental evidences are showing what? The structure of methane molecule is in tetrahedral manner. tetrahedral manner. So the structure of methane molecule, central atom is a carbon. So all four hydrogens are arranged in tetrahedral manner. So now these are the four hydrogens present around carbon. So now this is the structure of tetrahedral. Tetrahedral structure of methane. So now, whenever the methane molecule structure is like this, so here 1, 2, 3, 4, all bonds are having same energy. And these all bonds are having same properties in all aspects. But whereas in case of formation of methane molecule according to VBT, here we have two types of bonds are there. So one bond is formed between overlapping of s orbital of hydrogen, s orbital of carbon, and remaining three are what, p orbitals and s orbitals of carbon and hydrogen atoms. So there should be difference in energy. But here in the formation of methyl molecule, so all bonds are having equal energy and they are all properties of all bonds are equal in all aspects. So why it is taking place and what are the processes taking place in the formation of methyl molecule? So it should containing what? All same properties. So now here it is the term we are introducing. What is that? Hybridization. Okay, the term hybridization. Okay, so according to hybridization, in the formation of methane molecule, so all bonds are having similar or same properties in all aspects. So during hybridization, what happening and what are the factors are influencing hybridization? So in the next lecture, clearly I will explain. Thank you.